What's going on, gamers? Today we're going to be going over how to install and even some of the new features in extra utilities. Before we get into this tutorial, don't forget to give this video a like, subscribe, and click the notification bell so you can stay up to date on every tutorial we upload, just like this one. As you play through Minecraft, efficiency is often the difference between tedious work and playing at your own pace. Throughout the game, you're going to build stuff like mob farms and storage arrays just to make life easier. These are often trickier to build as the setup can be like super meticulous to build or have super annoying trade-offs, like having a huge farm in the middle of your build or taking up an entire room. This is a mod that adds a ton of new blocks and features that completely redefine the gameplay experience, like compressing blocks, like cobblestone to transporting items and power. There's a lot to unpack with this mod, and we're gonna show you just how easy it is to get it up and running on your Apex Minecraft server. We're gonna start off by showing you how to download extra utilities. You can visit the extra utility support webpage, which of course is gonna be linked in the description of this video. And once you're here, visit the files tab at the top of the page and then click on view all. Once you're on this page, there should be a little drop-down where you can sort by game version. Once you've found your version, click on it and just click the download button next to the file or the most recent one that you like for your server or client side. It's gonna take you to an alternate download page where once the file downloads, you can just click and drag it to a folder for easy access later on, somewhere like your desktop. Hop onto your Apex server panel and then go ahead and click stop. And once your server is fully offline, then you can scroll down to the game files section, or you can check at the top of your page to make sure that your server's at the same version that you downloaded for your version of extra utilities. Once you're sure you've got the same version of Forge for extra utilities that you've got running on your server, click on FTP file access and log in with your information. Then find your mods folder and click into your mods folder. Then go ahead and click on upload at the top left and open up the folder where you downloaded the extra utilities jar file to earlier and click and drag it to the right hand side of the page. Once your file's uploaded at 100% and uploaded 1 out of 1 file, you can click on the name of your server at the top of the page and either start or restart your server to get it back up and running. The client install is surprisingly simple too. All you need to do is make sure that Forge is installed on Minecraft before proceeding on. If you don't know how to install Forge, well, we already have a guide on it with written and video instructions as well. So now that you've gotten Forge installed, go ahead and jump onto the installations tab on your Minecraft launcher. This is gonna open your .minecraft folder, and from here you can go ahead and click into your mods folder. Then open up the folder where you downloaded your mod jar earlier too, and click and drag your extra utilities jar over to your Minecraft mods folder. Now you can click back on your Minecraft launcher and click on play. And now we're going to go over some of the cool additions that extra utilities adds to Minecraft. And first up is the mini chest. As the name suggests, it's both a mini chest physically and in terms of storage. Though it's lacking in storage capacity, its small size allows you to easily place it in a hard to reach location. It's allowing you to hide your most valuable items. Then there's pipe networks. They operate similarly to hoppers, but a pipe network allows you to transport a variety of items, liquid, and even power. And you have significantly more directional control and can move items upwards with ease. A common use for this would be to construct large storage arrays connecting chests to each other. Then there's mob spikes. Minecraft mob farms tend to be very methodical, allowing you to either obtain drops through vault damage or experience points by finishing them yourself. There's wooden spikes, which reduce health to half hearts, stone spikes, which slowly kill mobs, iron spikes, which kill mobs faster, and golden spikes, which means that mobs are going to die and then drop experience points. And diamond spikes will give player kill items on the mob drops, and creative spikes will instantly kill any mob. Then there's even new power sources, from windmills to solar panels. Each power block is going to have different requirements to function, such as being placed next to a stream. Power sources power stuff like the Quantum Quarry. It's an absolute beast for mining blocks and ores at ridiculous speeds. As it mines from a hypothetical dimension, it's not going to destroy any blocks or landscape from your existing world. To get started, all you need to do is place one Quantum Quarry in an inaccessible spot, meaning there's blocks of air all around it or a path beneath it. Now you're going to need to place a Quantum Quarry actuators on each of the six sides of the Quantum Quarry. And once you've done this, you can right-click the quarry to view the UI that makes it function. And now you're going to need to hook it up to a power source, and the quarry is really powerful, so you're going to need to have plenty of energy for it to function. If you don't have power adequately hooked up, you might notice that no blocks are appearing at first. However, to fix this, all you're going to need to do is put down a chest right next to any of the actuators. You should see the items flooding in immediately, which is going to fill the chest to the brim. Extra Utilities is a super useful mod, and one that's popular on a ton of servers. If you're looking for something new to try, and you want something that's not too complicated but it's going to give you a ton to do, you should definitely consider Extra Utilities for help with building mob farms and just making life easier in Minecraft. Well folks, that's all we've got for you today, and as always, we hope you liked this tutorial, and we hope you have lots of fun.
Thanks for watching. If you want to see more great content like this, then subscribe or click these videos. Until next time, gamers.